ZRP Bulawayo are the champions of the inaugural Trukambo Joshua Mukabukonkomo Top 8 tournament, following an efficient 3-0 victory over Boso at 90 in an exciting final played at Bulawayo's White City Stadium Saturday the 10th of December. The week-long tournament bankrolled to the tune of $10,000, or for that matter, bond in cash by Trukam mining agencies, attracted the interest of foreign scouts and saw a number of players identified from different sides that participated. Now they are on their way to Europe.
I have here, five or six, I don't know, but I think I take him now for the tie in Europe.
As if they knew, ZRP players had gestured of a 3-0 victory long before the start of the match, and they were on that road to victory after big defender Patrick Mbomampofu had been robbed of possession by pint-sized Raylunga on the edge of the ZRP box. But Mboma recovered to retain possession, and on clearance with a long ball, he initiated what would turn out to be the opening goal, with ZRP carving open the Boso at 90 midfield and defence. With right-back Graciano Chakafana hesitant, Mlungisi Ncube pounced to place his shot wide of keeper Nedrick Madea's diving attempts. Immediately after, Boso responded with a great pass in midfield from Muzi Dlamini, but his intended recipient Brandon Dube was just a shade too slow to beat the keeper to the ball. Boso at 90 were then hit a shattering second following some bad marking from a free kick that Arnold Mushingi headed across the face of goal for Kenneth Dube to finish. Boso still had a chance to creep back into the match, and had they been clinical in front of goal, they would have reduced the arrears when Brandon Dube sent Raylunga through, but the pint-sized forward, a handful too big Patrick Mbomampofu all afternoon, crushed his effort against the left upright. ZRP did not relax on their two-goal lead. They kept searching for more, and another decent attempt from the distance by Benginkosi Mguni was collected by Madea. Boso's search for a crucial one that would set the tone for their fight back was yielding good scoring opportunities, but their failure to be clinical in front of goal was their biggest letdown. Brandon Dube would again do well to release Lunga, who would not believe his eyes after slicing his shot wide of the left upright with only the keeper to beat. Encouraging for Boso must have been that the chances were coming, but discouraging should have been their failure to be as clinical as their opponents in front of goal. Percy Maphosa's fair shot at goal was well dealt with by ZRP keeper Aaron Ngwenya. It would end 2-0 in the policeman's favour at halftime, and the tide would carry on in the same fashion in the second half, with ZRP threatening every time they poured forward. With the match edging towards the end, substitute Eric Opiri made it 3 for ZRP after collecting a chip from co-substitute Ronald Gumede to waltz his way past the onlooking Boso defence before hammering the final nail into the Boso coffin. That goal signalled the departure of most Boso faithfuls that had come to rally behind their team, and shortly after, the referee blew to bring the final to the end. 3-0 win then for the impressive police side, a result that left their coach, Rogers Ndlovu, almost melting in elation.
I can't even express my feelings. I'm overwhelmed by emotions. I'm just happy. I give credit to the players, credit to the team, above all, credit to the Almighty. Such things are gifts from God.
His chairman, Sifiso Siziba, also could not suppress his emotions and expressed the taste of winning the cup.
Wow, my brother, this is so sweet. After a hard-fought journey, it was a long season, it was a difficult draw from the quarterfinals, playing the champions Bantu, going on to knock out Makakas, and now playing Boso 90. It's so sweet. We went through the toughest of all routes, and I'm very, very grateful to my players, the coaches, and all the ZRP community.
All the participating teams from the first round all the way to the final were presented with their cash prizes by Dennis Chuma, representing the sponsors. Boso at 90 may have lost, but on reflection, it was quite a fairy tale for the Highlanders developmental side, invited into the tournament to replace Technosphere, who were unable to travel for their opening match. Acting club chairman Modern Ngwenya said despite the loss, it was befitting that their developmental side made the final of the Mukabuko Cup in a year when the club was celebrating 90 years of existence.
There is no better way of celebrating 90 years of existence than our own development side going all the way through to the final of the Joshua Mukabuko Knockout Tournament.
Southern Region President Musa Mandaza expressed his gratitude to the sponsors and promised that his management team would leave no stone unturned to weed out indiscipline within his region.
We are so happy that we have had this tournament as we close the doors at the end of our wonderful season. And I'm so happy that the sponsors have shown confidence in Southern Region, the way we have run our own affairs. There's nothing that you have put under the carpet. We have exposed all the indiscipline in our region, and the sponsors, that's a plus on the region, and it's a plus on the way we have run football in this country.
More than just the cup, ZRP also produced the tournament's best goalkeeper, Aaron Ngwenya. Eric Opiri emerged the top goal scorer after banging in 3 goals for ZRP Bulawayo. Dennis Chuma, representative of the sponsors at Trukam Mining Limited, said they were delighted to partner with football and create employment for the youth as well as provide entertainment for the community. Chuma said his company was following in the footsteps of the late great Vice President Joshua Mqabuko Nkomo.
As the mining organization, we decided to offer this tournament to create the employment to our young guys, and also entertainment to the community as a whole. We wanted our youth, all the youth in Matoland, to participate in this tournament so that they easily expose themselves maybe to the national.
Boso at 90 received their $1,500 cash, with their coach Melusi Spanda widely touted as the man to take over the senior side in the future, lamenting the missed chances which he said could have turned around things for his youthful side.
They have created a lot of chances, most in the first half, but you didn't impair it. You didn't impair them. If you have scored that goal, hit the crossbar, we'll be talking something.
So the curtain coming down to the 2016 season, and indeed quite fitting that the closing event, an honor to the late great Vice President Joshua Mqabuko Nyongolo Nkomo, thanks to Trukam Mining.